back. You've made it all the way to video four. I'm Sarah Harnish, Young Living Diamond, and this is Kimberly Esposito, who has 23 years as working in skincare as an esthetician in one of the largest markets in the United States. And we're gonna take a moment here and just break down some danger zones of some of the chemicals that are in your home. And it's really important that you know this stuff, because this is the place you begin with your conviction on knowing what you need to be swapping out. And you know, you might look in your cabinet and say, oh my gosh, Sarah, there's like 50 things that I need to swap out. It's okay. Just start slow, start easy, pick the thing that convicts you the most, and that's your beginning place. Kim's house was not completely chemical free the first month that she got introduced into oils. Mine took a good 2 years to start swapping everything out in the cabinet. So don't beat yourself up. Don't feel like you're not doing a good job. You're doing a great job just by taking that first step of being aware of what's in your home and then being convicted and taking the steps to change it one product at a time. So let's break down just a few danger zones in your home. Nanoparticles are some of the most serious toxic substances in all of skincare. They're touted as a technological advance, like titanium dioxide is one of them, but they can cause tumors in cells. It's serious, it's not a joke. Number one and number four dioxane. So one and four dioxane are highly carcinogenic. Just to give you an example, those are found in Tide soap, in laundry soap. So look, when you're flipping over your products, look for number one and look for number four dioxane, a very, very dangerous nanoparticle that you don't want in your house. Skin gets rid of 1/4 of all the toxins in your body. It's the largest organ in your body, and it's why you can see what's on the inside of your body from the outside of your body. So here's a list of ingredients to avoid, and I want you to know that if you go to oilabilityteam.com, we've got this as a free download on the website right under this beauty school, so you can download it and print it off and do your own beauty school classes, or if you're just watching this from online, you can print it off and have it in your home so that you know which ingredients to look for. We're going to read through this list pretty quickly, but you can get a hard copy in front of you. Here's some of the top 10 offenders in your home. Lead is a heavy metal that's found in whitening toothpaste and lipsticks. It can cause neurotoxicity, brain damage, seizures, gastrointestinal issues, reproductive dysfunction, and kidney dysfunction. And I know you guys are aware of lead because you've been trying to switch over from lead-based paint. It's illegal in the United States, but it's still in a lot of beauty care products. Like a lot, like one of the top offenders is lipstick. Mm-hmm. Yeah, right, non-organic lipstick. You gotta be so careful. Formaldehyde is found in nail polishes, shampoos, baby shampoos, guys. Yeah. Liquid body soap. It's been linked to cancer. As an alternative, you can use safe nail polish. One of my favorites is Piggy Paint. You can find that on Amazon, and that doesn't have any formaldehyde in it. That's what I use on mine and my daughter's nails. For shampoo and liquid soap, just switch to Young Living's body care line. Parabens are preservative, and they're typically found on ingredients is propylparaben, methylparaben, ethylparaben, butylparaben. They're found in body creams, lotions, shampoos, as well as just about every beauty product that has water added to it. So if it's any kind of a product with water in it, you want to be careful, except for Young Living. Young Living doesn't use any parabens. They don't use anything on this list. They have been classified parabens as a known hormone disruptor, and they can cause cancer. So it's important you're not putting that stuff in your body. Phthalates is another one. Those were found in at least 72 different products that were tested, but they weren't listed on any label. None. I'm going to repeat that. They were found in 72 products, but they weren't listed on any label, which means they don't have to always be listed on the label. They were listed on nail polishes, so you want to be very careful with nail polishes. So phthalates, heavily used in shower curtains. It's what you smell when you hang a brand new shower curtain. You're like, oh, my bathroom's so new. This is amazing. No, it's not new, right? It's also used in air fresheners and in laundry detergents. It's a known hormone disruptor, and it can cause infertility. So instead of air fresheners, diffuser. Get a diffuser with a pure essential oil. Get those air fresheners out of your house. Nitrosamines are so prolific. This is another one that they're found in almost every skincare product on the planet, from baby shampoo to tanning lotions. Why I don't use any tanning lotions. Mascara, concealers, they're linked to cancer, and they don't have to be reported on bottle labels. BHA and BHT, also used in moisturizers and makeup as preservatives. They suspend your endocrine disruptors, and they may cause cancer. Coal tar dyes. Those are used in hair dyes and in cosmetics. You'll see it on a bottle with a CI followed by five different digits. They can cause cancer. and most contain heavy metals that are really toxic to the brain and to the central nervous system. DEA ingredients, also not safe. Those are used in creams and in foaming products such as shampoo, and those can be linked to cancer as well. Petroleum are used in some hair care products for shine, but also in lipsticks, lip balms, moisturizers. It's used in Vaseline. There was a story of a woman on our team who got a sample of lavender and then dumped the whole thing into a bottle of Vaseline. and my leader said, no, don't do that. What did you just do? Don't do that. It can be contaminated with polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, which can cause cancer. So just use the oil. Don't stick it in any Vaseline. Sodium lauryl sulfate is in just about every single laundry soap. Every single laundry soap. You ran out of the thieves' laundry soap
never
once. Switched to an organic laundry soap, and her daughter's skin just went crazy. So there is no sodium lauryl sulfate in anything that Young Living makes. But that is found in a lot of foaming cosmetics like shampoo, cleanser. It's found in bubble baths, and that can cause cancer. And none of Young Living's products contain any of these or any petrochemicals on the earth. Okay, we've wrapped up this video. On to the next video. You're doing great.
His Vision Films.